that's subject to the public records law, so I would imagine almost all the documents that would be auditable or needed for an audit would be public record, so we could handle it that way if we did not get voluntary cooperation.
Well, we've had so much cooperation with the public records law already with the ones we've been dealing with, I can't imagine us having any more problems. I think that's a really narrow-minded statement, quite frankly. I am very concerned about that, because already, after it was stated at the meeting when this came out, not to do that, we had an email come in that directed a city staff member to go to a location and take pictures of paint cans somewhere.
Call my name, I did it.
Okay, you did it.
Call my name, say Commissioner Portier.
You told me not to call your name, wasn't allowed. Commissioner Portier sent in an email that said, please send Peter Parkin down here to the Business Skills Center, or whatever it was, to take pictures of some paint cans that were in a closet and wanted to know how they got there. Dying to know how they got there, quite frankly, but I don't think it's right that we should be addressing city staff that way. I think it's very dangerous.
And you stopped me from getting the pictures, too. Tell him, let him know you took care of that right away.
Well, yeah.
I am not opposed to what Commissioner Miller's saying for Founder's Day, Brazilian Fest, and Mango Festival, to go looking at it. The amount of money is considering the amount of money to look into it compared to the amount of money that they have received in the past, and considering that they continue to receive money going forward, justifies, in my mind, looking at it. So I think it should be looked at. Talk about hints and allegations and innuendo. I think all three of those festivals have had certainly all sorts of allegations made at them. I am for looking into those three festivals. I think it's justified. What I am concerned with now is that we have people that are mentioned in this report that serve on boards for this city. And my big concern is that now that's going to be a distraction to these boards. So it's my recommendation right now is that we remove the people that are associated with this report who serve on boards, to go ahead and remove them to make sure we're not creating a distraction for anyone else that are on these boards.
At first, my initial reaction was pretty much the way you articulated your reaction. And that was my gut. I said, boy, Kessler gave us so much, I mean, stacks of books and big, thick report. I said, let's deal with this. People need to know in this city, if they're going to take money for any good works project, they need to know that there's accountability, there's records to be kept, just like we have to do in business, anybody, nonprofit or not. So I'm for complete an investment in purity, in transparency, and in good stewardship. So I say, do all of them and move forward.
I think we're going to find hundreds of thousands of dollars in complete waste.
$100,000 from the items mentioned by the city manager, authorizing him to execute an agreement for that purposes, finding them to be professional services there, and therefore not subject to the bidding procedures of our purchasing.
Yes, Commissioner Gantz?
Yes.
Commissioner Portier?
No.
Commissioner Popelski?
Yes.
Vice Mayor Miller?
Yes.
And Mayor Nolan?
Yes.
Group, which is the Mango Festival, that's due on June 18th, that had approval for $25,000.
Under the resolution that was adopted last year, before any sum in over $10,000 can be released for a charitable donation, it's required that there be a public hearing and they enter into an agreement. So you'd have to set it for a public hearing before that can be done.
Mango Festival did submit financial documents 2 weeks ago, but we have not reviewed them.
So they are here. Some of the members is here. Terry is here tonight, and some of the other board members, they were meeting up in my office, but I told them no need to wait on that.
First off, to go back to the point that I made about the people that are on the board, the advisory boards that we have, I do want to make the motion to remove them from the boards, to not create a distraction for those boards.
County City Charter, by motion and approval of three commissioners, anyone can be removed from any city board except as otherwise provided by state statute or charter, and that's where you get into the problem with the first board.
Before seconding that, could I ask you to consider an amendment to that?
What's that?
Would you also consider the removal of any board member who has sued the city or is suing the city?
Does that have to do?
Because you're doing it as part of removing people from a board. So
I'm doing it in direct relation to the Kessler report. My motion is strictly for the people that are named in the Kessler report. Okay. If you want to make a separate motion, go ahead. But
Anthony Davis, Complete Count Census Committee, Beulah Hill, Complete Count Census Committee, Dan Portier, Planning and Zoning Board, Marta Rivera, Community Relations Board, Edgardo Rivera Community Relations Board.
I understand what you're trying to do. I understand the spirit, but they've been named, but they have not been convicted. They've been accused and not convicted. Is there any way we could give this sort of a police officer does something and they remove him from duty, but they give him another function while he has an opportunity to investigate it? Is there something besides just removing? Could it be temporarily removing until the dust is settled?
I'm not looking for a temporary suspension. I'm looking for a removal right now, and I would absolutely be more than happy to look at bringing people back at a later date, but right now I'm looking for a removal.
I have a motion and a second. Can I have roll call, please?
Commissioner Gadz?
Yes.
Commissioner Portier?
No.
Commissioner Popelski?
Yes.
Vice Mayor Miller?
Yes.
And Mayor Nolan?
Yes.
The other portion of it would be to address the civil service, to take a look at that, whether it's warranted to do what we need to do, because I know there's some limitations we have based on the charter.